Kremlin is furious that Finland is now taking steps to join NATO as quickly as possible. Former Russian President Dmitry Medvedev warned that Russia will greatly boost its military presence in the region in response. But Moscow's brutal invasion of Ukraine has alarmed capitals across Europe. Finland's parliament is expected to endorse joining the alliance in the coming days, although full membership would probably take months to actually happen. In Ukraine, officials were quick to point out that Helsinki seems to be getting special treatment, whilst Kyiv's desire to join NATO goes nowhere.
We are very happy for our friends in Finland. And of course, it's absolutely logical steps. But in the same time, it shows the double standard of the alliance, because all the world now see how long period of time Ukraine decided to go to the alliance, but we still have not any concrete answer.
France and Germany are among the many countries welcoming Finland's likely NATO membership, though, and the Finnish people seem largely on board as well, as CNN's Nic Robertson reports from Helsinki.
In Helsinki, calm as leaders move the nation ever closer to NATO membership. A momentous announcement delivered without fanfare by Prime Minister and President, a two-paragraph joint statement. NATO membership will strengthen Finland. Finland would strengthen NATO. Finland must apply without delay. On the eve of the historic announcement, Finland's president explaining why it's not a threat to Russia, but Russia is to blame.
We increase our security and we do not take it away from anybody.
The Kremlin's response: this doesn't make the world any safer. Russia's foreign ministry doubling down, saying they'll take military action if their national security is under threat.
In Parliament, where the historic vote will happen, routine business continues, but lest Russia escalate tensions, calls for speed.
Joining to NATO should be as short as possible.
When the moment comes, likely early next week, Koskinen, a member of the PM's party, is sure the vote to join will carry easily.
The result may be around 180 out of 200 in favour of membership.
Politicians and public now, for the most part, in lockstep, wanting to join NATO.
People, of course, support, especially when Russia have attacked Ukraine.
Not just the invasion of Ukraine, but a history of rocky relations with Russia, spurring many here to reassess decades of neutrality.
I have a very old father, he's 96, so he was here when we had our wars in Finland with Russia. And he's been talking about, the Russians can come anytime. And I said, oh, my father, you're back in the 40s and take it easy. And they're not, yeah, you never know what the Russians, they can always come. I said, take it easy. And now I just had to say to him, well, you were right.
In a way, Finland has been preparing for this moment for more than a generation. They've been involved in plenty of NATO and other international military operations, from Iraq to Afghanistan to Kosovo, Bosnia, Lebanon.
Just last week, British troops were training here with Finnish, American and other NATO soldiers. Finland's accession is expected to be fast-tracked. Nevertheless, the Nordic nation pressing its case with allies, mindful Russia is watching.
Finland holds solid democratic credentials that meet NATO's membership criteria and has a strong and credible national defense that is interoperable with NATO.
No panic here, and according to officials, no new Russian threat either. The starting gun, though, clearly fired in a massive geopolitical shift. Nic Robertson, CNN, Helsinki, Finland.
Joining me from Helsinki now is Petteri Orpo, the chairman of the Defence Committee in the Finnish Parliament. Thank you so much for joining us. No moves have actually been made yet. I know your Prime Minister and President have said they want to expedite this membership. It has to go through the Parliament first, doesn't it? So are you confident the Parliament will next week approve this application to NATO?
Yes, now, because we have statements from the President and the Prime Minister. Next, the President and the Ministerial Group for Foreign Affairs will give a proposal of NATO membership to the Parliament, probably on Sunday. The Parliament will discuss the matter and vote on it on Monday or Tuesday, when we can officially send our membership application to the NATO headquarters in Brussels.
So when would you be a member of NATO? Would it be a matter of months as opposed to years?
I hope it's a matter of weeks and months, not years. I hope that the process will be very fast.
It's obviously being seen as a very provocative move by Moscow. We've got former President Medvedev now threatening to boost military assets in the region. You've got the Russian Foreign Ministry saying this is a radical change in policy. Is that the sort of reaction that you expected? Because undoubtedly, it is a radical change in policy from your formerly neutral status, which many people would argue was a defence in its own right.
Mm. At first, I want to say that Finland has not been neutral since we joined the European Union in 1995. During the Cold War, we had to be neutral in a pragmatic way because Soviet Union. We have not been part of military alliance, but we have been part of a political alliance, the EU. We have belonged to the West for 25 years. In Russia's eyes, we are already part of Western group, and that is what we also think ourselves. We have also had deep cooperation with NATO and United States and UK before.
So, in terms of what Medvedev is saying, increasing military assets in the region, could your strategy backfire because it's seen as a more provocative stance, joining NATO, doubling the border between NATO and Russia, and therefore, as a result of that, Moscow sending more military assets to the region and therefore potentially creating a greater threat to you?
Yes, Russia has constantly threatened Finland and Sweden, just like its other neighbors. They have stated some about military technical measures. I believe they would concentrate some troops near border. However, their arms are now stuck in Ukraine. But they could also launch cyber attacks and disinformation, as well as hybrid attacks, such as weaponizing immigration. But I want to say that we are not afraid in Finland. We are prepared and ready for everything. I don't think they can launch an invasion, and we are very strong own army and own defense, because we have never dropped the ball when it comes to defense. We are the nation that is ready to defend itself fiercely, and Russia knows it. And what comes about our long border, we will take our share.
There's some frustration in Kyiv at the moment because they aren't able to apply to NATO currently because they're in a conflict. You're not in a conflict, so you can apply to NATO. Are you concerned that the Russians may invade in a small way and therefore prevent you applying to NATO? That might be their response.
I'm sure that there will be their response. But as I told, we are not afraid. We are well prepared. And there's not much what they can do new. We know almost all the threats. And it's difficult to see what new they can do against us. But as I say, we are ready.
OK, Finnish MP Petteri Orpo, thank you very much indeed for joining us on Helsinki.
Thank you so much.